Hello everybody, this is Ultimate Lifeform RB, and welcome to a new episode of Let's Play Mega Man 2 for the Nintendo Entertainment System. In our last episode, we did Wily Stages 3 and 4, and now we have arrived in the final part of the game. It's time for Wily Stage 5, where we come across a room filled with teleporters. In these teleporters, we will find the 8 robot masters of this game that we defeated to get to Dr. Wily's Fortress, and now we have to fight all 8 of them in one run in a series of rematches. This is pretty much the build-up to the final boss of the game, so yes, we are essentially at the end of the game. So let's not waste any more time, let's get with the boss rematches, let's get this started. Well, that didn't go so well. Let's try that again. Alright, so that is it. The boss rush is done, and now an extra teleporter has opened up in the teleporter room, and we are pretty much at the point where it is finally time to go after Dr. Wily himself. It's time for the final confrontation. Say hello to Wily Machine 2, called so because it is the second Dr. Wily Machine. You face a Dr. Wily Machine in some form or another in every Mega Man game, and yes, I know I died right there. Epic fail on my part. Let's try that again. So this Wily Machine comes in 2 phases. This first phase is weak to the Atomic Fire, but because I have trouble pulling off that move, I just stick to the Mega Buster, or the Arm Cannon, whichever you want to call it. And you just shoot the windshield to knock it out, and then here, you'll want to use the air shooter, because that is one of the weaknesses of the second phase of Wily Machine 2. And right here, I'm using an energy tank because I don't want to take a chance. I really don't want to go back to the start. And there you go. But we ain't done yet. Yes, there's an extra part. And this part, I'll admit, the first time I went through this part, I found this area kind of spooky because there's no music or anything at all. And you're just doing this long fall down a shaft. And then Next, we're going to get to a part where you have this weird liquid dripping down from the ceiling. And all you get is this eerie dripping noise. Like, there's no music or anything. It's kind of creepy. Also, you don't want this liquid to touch you. It'll shave off a lot of HP if you take a hit. So you want to get the pattern down of the droplets so you can walk by without getting hurt. And we should be approaching the boss door. There it is right there. And it's time for the real final boss of this game. Look, Mega Man's jumping for joy. He's pumped up. I'm pumped up. Let's go ahead and do this. Alright, Dr. Wily, what do you got for us this time? And oh my goodness. He just transformed! Say hello to the final boss of Mega Man 2. This boss is simply known as Alien. But he's actually not that difficult once you know what to do. The only weapon that harms Alien is the Bubble Lead. Yes, probably the least likely weapon you'd expect to use in the final battle is the Bubble Lead. Just watch the guy's pattern, watch his shots, dodge as best you can, and just keep hitting him with the Bubble Lead. No other weapon will affect him. In fact, if you try to use any other weapon, you'll actually heal him, according to what I've read. But, as it turns out, it's all just a holographic projection. Game over, Wily. Game over. And that is it, ladies and gentlemen. That is the end of the final boss of Mega Man 2, and that is pretty much the end of the game. So Dr. Wily goes down, and we're treated to this extended sequence where it's just Mega Man. We show Mega Man walking, and we see all these pictures of the seasons and such. Like, I don't really get the point of this little cutscene. I mean, I like the music. It's a nice little musical piece. But, you know, I don't really understand the point of this. I mean, is Mega Man, like, is he contemplating why he has to fight? Or is he wondering why he was made or something? Like, I really don't get the idea here. Or maybe he's just trying to clear his head of all the insanity he just went through over the course of the game. You know, taking out the 8 Robot Masters and such. I will admit, though, I like this last shot where it's just his helmet. Very, very interesting sequence. Anyway, it's time for the credits, and that's pretty much the end of the game right here. And at first, we get to introduce the people who designed the 8 Robot Masters in this game, because a lot of the Robot Masters in Classic Mega Man were actually based off of contest submissions from all over Japan and such, according to what I've read. So it was sort of like fan input, basically. Like, people were allowed to submit their own Robot Master ideas, and like, the developers of the game would select the Robot Masters from the contest and I guess add their own little modifications or whatever to make them fit into the game. And that's pretty much it for Mega Man 2. Mega Man 2, it's a great game. It's probably one of my favorite NES games of all time. And this is coming from someone who didn't grow up with the NES. It's only recently, relatively recently, that I've been able to really go in depth into the Nintendo library for the original NES, but I've been able to discover a lot of great games, like, you know, the original Metroid. I did an LP of that, you know, the Mario Brothers games, and, you know, of course, Classic Mega Man, like this game. And, you know, it's a great game, you know, for its time. And even today, I think it still holds up. I mean, the weapons are all fun to use, and it's interesting to figure out the uses for the different weapons and everything. The music is fantastic. You know, the graphics are great for their time and everything. And Mega Man 2 all around is just a great game. And I don't know if I'm ever going to do any other classic Mega Man games or any other Mega Man games in general. I might somewhere down the line return to this series, especially if anyone might want to see me do another Mega Man game. But for the moment, I think in terms of Mega Man LPs, I'll just leave it at this game, because this game is the one I'm most familiar with, and it is, you know, I'm with a lot of other people. I do sort of rank it as the best out of the classic Mega Man games, out of the ones I've played anyway. And, you know, it's just, you know, I thought it was just a fun game to do an LP for, you know, just a little something different from what I usually do. And that's pretty much it for this LP, and that's pretty much it for this video. So this is Ultimate Lifeform RB signing out for now. If you folks liked what you saw in this video, please don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I would greatly appreciate it as always. I hope you guys enjoyed watching this LP as much as I enjoyed doing it. And I'll see all of you in my next video and my next LP. See you folks later. Ultimate Lifeform RB out. Like what you see in this video? Want to see more? Then please support my channel by liking, commenting, and subscribing. I would greatly appreciate it. And also, don't forget to like me on Facebook.